welcome to this, our Wednesday, October 16, 2019 edition of News Update. I'm Ashley Scotland. First, the top stories we're tracking this evening. Chief Justice fails to rule in cabinet resignation. Two men caught by Khan with over 94 pounds of marijuana. Government-nominated commissioners attempting to remove 20,000 persons from voters' list. And in sport, Ghana Football Federation signs historic memorandum of understanding with the Denmark Football Federation. These and more coming up after the break. Stay with us.
Modern Optical Service has made it even better by introducing its budgeted spectacle line, starting as low as $10,000 for single vision lens and $12,000 for bifocal lens, available in tinted or clear, complete spectacles at affordable prices. So hurry down to our main office at 316 Middle Street or Lot 14 Diamond Public Road opposite Demerara Bank. Enjoy over 60 years of eye care experience at affordable prices. Modern Optical Service, your eye care professionals.
You can be a millionaire by only spending $100 on a Daily Million ticket. Simply pick any five numbers from 1 to 26, or you can buy a quick bet for your chance to win the Daily Millions. Purchase your tickets daily, Monday through Saturday, to get a chance to win $1 million every day. So, feeling lucky? Then buy a Daily Millions ticket today. Remember, a ticket today could make you rich today.
The Guyana Elections Commission would be conducting a claims and objections exercise from the 1st of October 2019. Persons have until the 4th of November 2019 to make a claim to be on the list if you will be 18 years or older by the 31st of December 2019, a Guyanese citizen by birth, descent, naturalization, or registration, a citizen of a Commonwealth country living in Guyana for a period of no less than 1 year preceding the 31st of December 2019, persons who require changes or corrections to their particulars as stated on the preliminary list of electors, such as names, occupations, and transfers in relation to their addresses, can also do same during the claims and objections period. You must present the relevant original documents in order for the transaction to be completed. Don't delay. Visit the nearest GCAM registration office today. For more information, visit our website at www.gcam.org.gy. Follow GCAM on Facebook at Guyana Elections Commission. Contact us on 225-02779 or 223-9653. Email pro@gcam.org.gy or the nearest GCAM registration office.
Looking for fresh, tender, and flavorful meat? Then check out Rossignol Butchery for steaks, burgers, sausages, minced meat, fish, and chicken. For a tasty, attractive cocktail, we have a wide variety of packaged deli meats and cheeses to decorate your platter. We also stock a wide assortment of canned goods, seasoning salts, sauces, and marinade, all in a highly hygienic, welcoming atmosphere with warm and welcoming staff to cater to all your needs. Rossignol Butchery, we meet your needs. 73 to 74 Church Street, Georgetown. Telephone number 223-00.
Welcome back. Now for the news in detail. Chief Justice Robson George Wilshire today failed to rule that the cabinet, including the president, stands resigned. However, she pointed out that the CCJ did make such a ruling.
The Chief Justice today refused to grant the fix-the-date application filed by Anil Nandlal, seeking to compel the cabinet, including the president, to resign. Justice George Wilshire noted that the Caribbean Court of Justice did make a ruling on the matter. She highlighted that the CCJ said the cabinet, including the president, stood resigned due to the passage of the motion of no confidence. However, the CCJ noted, notwithstanding this, the tenure in office of the cabinet, including the president, as well as the government as a whole, is on a different footing. The Chief Justice noted that the applicant, Nandlal, may have been dissatisfied that the CCJ did not make the pronouncement in explicit terms, but he cannot seek to overturn or reinterpret it by filing such an application to the High Court. She noted that she is bound by the ruling of the higher court. The CJ labeled Nandlal's application as wholly mischievous, vexatious, and an absolute abuse of the process of the court before striking it out. He is also ordered to pay $500,000 to the respondent, Basil Williams. Meanwhile, Nandlal explained his disappointment with the ruling.
There's a cabinet that's refusing to resign, and the Constitutional Court of the country is telling us that because the CCJ did not make that order, then forever we are in perpetual error. In other words, the doctrine of precedent and the doctrine of stare decisis are now superior to the Constitution of the country. The Constitution is the supreme law, not no ordinary principle of stare decisis or doctrine of precedent. Those are elementary, very low-rank principles. The Constitution is the supreme law of Guyana, and that, unfortunately, is not being upheld by the court.
In contrast, Attorney General Basil Williams is elated with the decision of the CJ.
The Honorable Chief Justice was correct by saying it's a vexatious matter, you know, and Ms. Nandlal has to be careful that he does not become a vexatious litigant, because he was part and parcel of the representation of the leader of the opposition at the all levels, CCJ, Court of Appeal, High Court. And it was not fit for him and right for him as an officer of the court to try to seek to come to the first instance judge and try to raise the same issue again.
Nandlal has promised to appeal the matter. Godfrey Brooms, MTV News Update.
People's Progressive Party nominated commissioners have threatened legal action against the commission if it intends to remove names from the National Register. The APNUAFC nominated commissioners are attempting to remove some 20,000 persons from the list because of their failure to uplift their ID cards.
The opposition People's Progressive Party nominated commissioners have raised concern that it learned that the commission wants to remove names from the National Register of Registrants. The last statutory meeting, the commission discussed the removing of at least 20,000 names from the National Register of Registrants. Thousands of persons are still to uplift their national identification cards, having applied for the document several years ago. Commissioners Sais Conraj, Rupsin Ben, and Bibi Shadik are insisting that the act is an attempt to remove persons from the voters' list. Chief Justice Roxanne George Wilshire last August ruled that persons cannot be removed from the National Register of Registrants. There are 646,625 names on the preliminary list of electors. Some 370,822 persons were registered from the suspended house-to-house registration and will be put up for public scrutiny. This attempt by the coalition to remove the names is a real test for the recently appointed GCOM chairperson, Justice Claudette Singh, since she was the presiding judge who ruled in 1997 that an identification card is not a prerequisite to vote. As a matter of fact, tens of thousands of Guyanese vote in the past elections using their passports. Also, each polling station are usually equipped with a manifold of the names of voters and their photos, therefore making any form of ID unnecessary for an eligible person to vote. Sandy Ramotar for MTV's News Update.
The Federation of Independent Trade Unions has warned that freedom of speech might be under threat after a number of protesters were reportedly harassed by the Guyana police force during a demonstration last week on the west coast of Demerara. Details from Sandy Ramotar.
The Federation of Independent Trade Unions of Guyana has raised concern that persons demonstrating their constitutional right protest might be under threat. The umbrella organization in a statement has taken note of the significant increased security forces in the presence of Mr. Granger. The union raised concern after a number of protesters were detained and later released without charge at a police station on the west coast of Demerara. The protesters were at the time protesting Mr. Granger's presence at the Saraswati Vidya Nikatan's school graduation last week. The union reminded that it is legal for Guyanese to demonstrate their disagreement on political matters. It says such action demonstrates oppression and intimidation and a threat to the freedom of speech. The union pointed out that the presence of security forces are being directed to Mr. Granger at a time when the nation is gripped with incidences and crime continues to spiral. This came as the APNU-AFC-controlled Ghana National Broadcasting Authority attempted to silence two media houses for disseminating views about the coalition. The opposition-owned Freedom Radio and independent television station Multi-Technology Vision were fined by the GNBA. The two media houses have since filed legal proceedings against the GNBA board, which was illegally constituted. Those matters are pending before the courts.
Officials of the Customs Anti-Narcotic Unit, KANU, interdicted a quantity of suspected compressed marijuana at Parika on Tuesday at around 3 hours. KANU says the drugs were uncovered at the Parika Public Road East Bank, Essequibo. The suspected narcotic is 42.824 kilograms of cannabis. Two persons were arrested, Shafiq Latif, 39, of 535 Tushin Newhousen Scheme, and Naresh Totaram, 35, of 632 Tushin East Bank, Essequibo. Both men were occupants of a Spasia motor car when it was interdicted by the ranks with two bulky salt bags containing the narcotics in the back seat. Both men are in custody assisting with investigations. Though unconstitutional in office as a caretaker president, David Granger will be utilizing a huge chunk of state resources to launch a commission of inquiry into the deadly Friendship smash-up. That accident claimed the lives of five persons and left another critical. Details from Sandy Ramadar.
In ordering the COI, Head of State David Granger emphasized that the extremely disturbing accident saddens him. He laid his instructions to launch the commission to the Police Commissioner Acting Nigel Hoppy. Mr. Granger mandated that the COI be headed by a person no lower in rank than the Deputy Commissioner to determine how such an accident could have occurred and also to make recommendations to prevent a recurrence. Mr. Granger assured whatever the cause of the accident, the government, the administration of the Guyana Police Force and the Guyana Defense Force, and the National Security Committee will take every step to ensure that the roads are used safely by all members of the security forces. He promised that steps will also be taken to ensure that regulations, standing operating procedures, inspections, and the careful selection and the training of drivers are measures which are put in place so as to prevent a recurrence. Godfrey Brooms, MTV News Update.
Still ahead, Blairmon factory workers protest for pay raise and better working conditions. Woman shot, robbed at Harbour Bridge Mall. And in sport, Ghana Football Federation signs historic memorandum of understanding with the Denmark Football Federation. These and more when we return. Stay with us.
Mark?
I'm in the kitchen.
This is amazing! I love your tiles.
Make an impression with the finest tiles imported by Lens. Lens has a huge selection of various tiles for your wall, floor, and pool needs. All of our tiles are of grade A quality, which are the highest quality tile rated. That means they last longer and are less likely to damage or crack. We're the sole distributor for many reputable companies around the world. At Lens, we have special deals for contractors and bulk shoppers. Shop at any of our three locations to get the best in tiles. Lens, our product, your creation.
Did you know almost one-third of deaths in Guyana are heart-related? Chronic inflammation is the root cause of atherosclerosis, the process that leads to cholesterol-clogged arteries. You can now lower high triglyceride levels with Omega XL and reduce the dangerous inflammation that causes these problems. So to ensure a healthy heart and reduce your risk of disease, get your Omega XL today. Live long, stay strong with Omega XL.
Everything is connected, our planet, our water sources, including the water we drink. Sometimes harmful bacteria end up in our streams and canals. Although treated, the risks are high. You can prevent this pollution and contamination by maintaining your septic tank and grease traps. Call the experts at Puran Brothers Disposal Incorporated on 264-1239 or 603-5050. Keeping it clean is what we do best.
You know, since me find out about Tire Future Shop, me house look nicer than you one. Hey, hey, credit rate. How you can afford to buy all them things?
Let me tell you.
Now me not get catch again. Our secret.
No, come now, man. I'm magic. You're too fast. Mind the business.
Excuse me, Uncle. Tell me something. How credit can afford to buy so much thing from my honey now walk no way?
It's because now we introduce our new discount card.
Apply now for your discount card at Tayo Future Shop. Every time you shop using your discount card, your percentage increases. Start from 5% off. Your next purchase, 7% off. Then 10% off, etc. Until you start getting wholesale and factory price. Check in store for more details. Conditions apply.
Help me get me Tayo discount card. Wait, man. What you gotta do next, man? Buy the whole entire store?
Welcome back. You're watching MTV's News Update. Factory workers from the Blairmont Estate in Berbice this morning picketed the Ghana Sugar Corporation, demanding better working conditions and a pay raise.
Factory workers from the Blairmont Estate this morning staged a demonstration to heighten the demand for a pay rise and better working conditions. The workers complained of being treated unfairly after an employee has been promoted without due process. The strike has stalled the grinding operation at the factory and is expected to affect the work production of the cane cutters. The workers have been on a strike since October 14.
Bad money is fair.
Bad money is fair.
Bad money is fair.
This is not fair, Grizzle.
Treat our work fairly.
I will be
in favor
of them in the factory.
The factory workers are looking to engage the Ghana Sugar Corporation to address the matter. The Ghana Agricultural and General Workers Union is not optimistic that Mr. Granger will approve the petition it submitted to approve an increase in wages. Mr. Granger told the union that he will have the petition examined by the sugar company, after which the union will be informed of the findings. Sandy Ramotar for MTV's News Update.
Region 1 Burimawine is the most at-risk location in the country should an oil spill occur offshore, according to the preliminary findings in the National Oil Spill Contingency Plan. iNews Ghana is reporting that the draft plan, which is scheduled to be completed in the first week of November, was released on Wednesday at the final stakeholder workshop held at the Hermanson Lodge in Georgetown. The plan details the standard operating procedures and assigns responsibilities to various state entities in the event of an oil spill. According to the document, regions 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 are likely to be most affected by an oil spill, particularly if it occurs offshore. However, it singles out region 1 as the most at-risk coastal region given the location of current and upcoming oil exploration and production. Moreover, the document states that the likelihood of oil reaching shore following an oil spill offshore is to be assessed in a risk assessment, taking into consideration, among other things, travel distance, wave and wind activity, as well as location of the oil rigs. It pointed out that communities located immediately along and are washed by the Atlantic Ocean are anticipated to be the most at risk if oil is to reach shore following a spill. In the wake of the death of gold miner Dion Stuhl, the Ghana Gold and Diamond Miners Association has expressed disappointment that the Ghana Police Force are not frequently patrolling. The association is calling for better protection of citizens.
Dion Stuhl was gunned down at point blank on Monday last inside a car. He had just arrived at a gold dealership in the Silver Street, Newtown, when two armed men pounced on him and his security. Stuhl, after receiving multiple shots, was able to return fire, hitting one of the bandits. Both gunmen escaped empty-handed in an awaiting car. Stuhl, who collapsed in his car, later died at the Georgetown Public Hospital Corporation. In wake of the brutal killing, the Ghana Gold and Diamond Miners Association is calling for justice for its member. the GGDMA called on the Guyana Police Force to focus on addressing, and I quote, real crime and the removing of criminal elements, end of quote. The association is convinced that there is an upsurge in crime and the minister in charge must address it. According to the GGDMA, both the police and the Guyana Defense Forces must weed out rogue elements so business persons can feel secured. The association questions, where are the police patrols and the hundreds of vehicles the force received? Godfrey Brooms, MTV News Update.
Nili Singh, 42, was about to open her store at the Harbour Bridge Mall when she was attacked by a lone gunman, iNews Guyana reports. Singh, a businesswoman of Diamond House in Scheme East Bank, Demerara, is the owner of the Best Value pawn shop located at the Harbour Bridge Mall. On Wednesday at around 10 hours 5, she was about to open the store when she was approached by a male armed with a handgun who was waiting in front of the Harbour Bridge Mall. The suspect reportedly held onto the businesswoman's bag and a scuffle ensued during which the victim was shot in the region of her right lower leg and relieved of the bag. She was rushed to a city hospital where her condition is listed as stable. Here is Celine Griffith with MTV's Court Roundup.
A former cane cutter was today handed down two life sentences for the gruesome killing of his 55-year-old mother-in-law and 9-year-old stepdaughter, whom he chopped to death in 2014. Joshua Franklin, 48, appeared before High Court Judge Justice Sandile Kisoon earlier this month and pleaded guilty to the two manslaughter charges. Franklin admitted that on December 18, 2014, at Tushan Housing Scheme, he unlawfully killed Bibi Zalima Khan and Ashley Boudou. On the day in question, Franklin reportedly invaded his mother-in-law's house and attacked her and the little girl with a cutlass. During the mayhem, Franklin also chopped his reputed wife Geeta Boudou multiple times about the body, severing her left hand from the wrist down, but she managed to escape and hide in the veranda of a neighbor's house. It was also reported that Franklin killed his reputed wife's male friend Floyd Drakes during the chopping spree. This case will come up soon for a report. Before sentencing, the man stated that he was sorry for what happened and pleaded with the judge to be merciful. However, the prosecution asked the court to consider the fact that Franklin used his skill as a cane cutter to slaughter his stepdaughter and mother-in-law, and informed the court that even as the girl tried to escape from the ordeal, the heartless man pulled her back and chopped her to death. The prosecution further explained that Franklin premeditated committing the act because he was armed with two cutlasses when he went on the chopping spree. Justice Kisoon, after considering Franklin's domestic history and the nature of the case, sentenced him to two life imprisonment for the charges with the possibility of parole after serving 30 years. The sentencing will run concurrently. In another matter, a former sawmill worker was today sentenced for the killing of a 52-year-old man who was stabbed to death during an argument at his home in 2014. 35-year-old Travis Hyman was initially charged with murder but opted to plead guilty to the lesser count of manslaughter and confessed that on July 21, 2014 at Strathcampbell, Myconi, East Coast, Demerara, he unlawfully killed Alvy Israel Richmond. According to reports, Hyman shared a relationship with Richmond's sister. On the day in question, Richmond and Hyman had an argument over space in the washroom when Hyman became overly aggressive and stabbed Richmond to the heart with a knife, resulting in injuries to which he later succumbed. Hyman's attorney told the court that he is remorseful and threw himself at the mercy of the court to make amends for his wrongs. The attorney also stressed that Hyman never intended to kill Richmond and stated that he violated the trust of the man's family because he was close with them. However, the prosecution asked the judge to consider the weapon that was used in the murder and explained that Richmond was killed in the bathroom while in the comfort of his own home by Hyman, a visitor, who rendered no assistance to Richmond but instead ran away from the crime scene. Finally, the state asked the court to send a strong message to the perpetrator and potential offenders who might consider such crimes. The court also heard that Hyman was previously charged for cannabis, gun possession, and now murder. After listening to both sides, Justice Sandile Kisoon sentenced Hyman to 20 years for the murder of Alvy Richmond. The time spent on remand will be deducted from the sentence. Reporting for MTV's Court Roundup, Celine Griffith.
Coming up after the break, MTV's Sport Update and more. Stay with us.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas everywhere you go. Take a look and five and ten, glistening once again, with candy canes and silver lanes aglow. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas, toys in every store. But the prettiest sight to see is the holly that will...
It happens. Your septic tank is full. All the waste from your toilet goes into your septic tank through the sewage line. When your tank is full, the two most common indicators are an overflowing tank and an overflowing toilet. It is recommended that Sevon's Waste Management empty your septic tank every 2 to 3 years to avoid any embarrassment. And before you can say, shh, it's gone. Call Sevon's Waste Management today at 218-1455 or 218-1156.
Now using Softex toilet tissue, available in leading supermarkets countrywide. Softex is always silky smooth because it's made from virgin pulp and babies love it. Softex comes available in single rolls, economy pack, six pack, and one dozen packages. Just perfect for any budget. Manufactured and distributed by BPATS Paper Manufacturing, Eccles Industrial Site. For more information, telephone 622-4197.
Over the years, ISG has been providing all sectors across Guyana with quality products and outstanding customer service. Proud distributor of NP and Ultra lubricants, engineered for tropical conditions. International trucks and parts, leading the change. SEM Machinery, a Caterpillar brand. SKF bearings and mounted products. Napa batteries. Tide power generators. Discover the greatest source of power. Industrial Supply of Guyana Inc. The best opportunity to make the right choice.
The Guyana Football Federation, in its effort to solidify a platform for football in Guyana, signed a historic football development memorandum of understanding with the Denmark Football Association to further develop football in Guyana.
This is the second bilateral agreement between a Caribbean member association and a country from within the UEFA family. President of the GFF, Wayne Ford, informed the signing of this historic memorandum of understanding with the DBU produces new and exciting opportunities for the long-term development of Guyana's football and to see to the implementation of key objectives and programs. The DBU and the GFF's collaboration paves the way for potentially transforming the sport of football. President of the DBU, Jesper Moller, disclosed he looks forward to working along with the GFF, adding the partnership can prove beneficial to both federations. He highlighted the GFF and the DBU have one common goal. They both intend to participate in the 2026 FIFA World Cup.
First of all, it's about getting together, building bridges, having discussions. And we quite soon found some common goals that we will try to achieve before 26, because in 26 we have one common goal that we want to achieve. We should both countries participate in the World Cup in this confederation. I'm not sure in the same group because we want to go to the to the final. I don't know with you. We didn't discuss that. No. We can't agree about any results. You know, that's not allowed. So we have to go into the pitch I'm sure we will execute on this agreement. So I really look forward to working together with you all. Thank you very much.
President Muller indicated he is quite sure objectives of both the GFF and the DBU will be met by 2020. Chelsea Lee, reporter from MTV's Sports Update.
Manchester United midfielder Paul Pogba has been ruled out of Sunday's Premier League meeting with leaders Liverpool at Old Trafford. The Frenchman, 26, is suffering from a foot injury that has limited him to 2 appearances since the end of August. United are 2 points clear of the relegation zone, while Liverpool have an 8-point lead at the top. Goalkeeper David De Gea is also a doubt for the game. He will have scans on Thursday on a groin injury. Argentine Sergio Romero will deputise against Liverpool if De Gea is ruled out with the injury that forced him off in the second half of Spain's Euro 2020 qualifier with Sweden on Tuesday. Pogba had last played in the 1-1 draw at home to Arsenal on September 30. He missed United's 1-0 defeat at Newcastle before the international break and has failed to recover in time to face Liverpool. It has been quite an eventful year for the golf, and Guyana's local players are geared and ready for the 2019 Guyana Open Golf Tournament, which expects more than 50% of international players come next month.
President of the LGC, Alim Hussein, disclosed it has been an exciting year for golf, highlighting this year's Open Tournament is expected to be one of the best Opens in the club's history. Fierce competition is expected from newcomers Barbados as they intend to knock Guyana off of the champion pedestal. This year's Open will see participation from Barbados, Suriname, French Guiana, Trinidad, the United States and Canada. Current Guyana Open champion Avinash Prasad told this newscast his preparations have been going well and he is quite confident that he will win the tournament and continue his reign as champion.
My preparation was going good because I just come off from the tournament in Suriname and I did well. I won the tournament and I'm keeping practicing and my preparation is going good. I'm very confident that I'm going to win the tournament again Open.
Meanwhile, Women's Open champion Dr. Joanne Dio informed in order to facilitate the huge number of players, the tournament will tee off earlier than usual. Dio added, a number of local and away tournaments have been held, highlighting the local players have received great exposure and practice. The Lusignan Golf Club anticipates the local players will continue to shine as they always do to keep the title. The 2019 Guyana Open Golf Tournament is set to tee off on November 26 and 27 at the Lusignan Golf Club. Chelsea Lee, reporter from MTV's Sports Update.
Teenager Coco Gauff was knocked out of the Luxembourg Open in the first round just days after winning her maiden WTA title. American world number 71 Gauff, 15, was beaten 6-4, 6-0 by Russian 8th seed Anna Blinkova in just 59 minutes. Gauff became the youngest player to win a WTA title in 15 years in beating former French Open champion Jelena Ostapenko in the Linz Open final. Gauff and compatriot Katie McNally are in the women's doubles quarterfinals. I'm very happy with my performance, said world number 66 Blinkova, who will play Germany's Tatjana Maria in the second round. I didn't make a lot of mistakes and I had the right tactics. I was calm and I did my job well today. I was very focused. I know she's a great player and I knew she was coming off of a WTA tournament win, so I was well prepared, she said. The Guyana Table Tennis Association, in partnership with the Guyana Olympic Association and Pan American Sports Organization, have recruited an ITTF Level 1 coach to serve as the school's tennis coach.
Candace McKenzie will serve as a school's table tennis coordinator coach to support and work with the GTTA's School's Athlete Development Pathway Project. The project is a collaborative initiative between the Guyana Olympic Association, the National Sports Commission, the Guyana Teachers Union and the Government of Guyana, based on a proposal made by the GTTA. The project has seen over 200 teachers from the selected schools trained in the ITTF 12-hour supervisory level training program. 90 Stag Elite training tables, balls and rackets were procured by the GOA and have been distributed to selected schools. Chelsea Lee, reporter from MTV's Sports Update.
Shivnarine Chandapal and Ryan Lara are among the big names set to feature in a 2020 tournament to be played in Mumbai in 2020.
The tournament, dubbed Road Safety World Series, aims to promote road safety, and the first season is to be played between February 2 and 16. The featured teams are West Indies Legends, India Legends, Australia Legends, South Africa Legends, and the Sri Lanka Legends. It is understood that a total of 110 players, all retired, have confirmed their participation in the tournament, which would be based on the franchise model prevailing across domestic T20 leagues around the world. The participating teams have been restricted to only test-playing countries for the first season. The proceeds from the tournament itself would be utilized by the Road Safety Cell to promote the cause, in addition to highlighting how India ranks the highest in the world in terms of deaths caused on roads. Some other prominent names include Sachin Tendulkar, Muthiah Muralitharan, Brett Lee, Jacques Callis and Virender Sehwag. Chelsea Lee, reporting from TV's Sports Update.
More news after the break. Stay with us.
Over the years, ISG has been providing all sectors across Guyana with quality products and outstanding customer service. Proud distributor of NP and Ultra lubricants, engineered for tropical conditions. International Trucks and Parts, leading the change. SEM Machinery, a Caterpillar brand. SKF Bearings and Mounted Products. Napa Batteries, Tide Power Generators. Discover the greatest source of power. Industrial Supply of Guyana Inc., the best opportunity to make the right choice.
Welcome back. You're still with MTV's News Update. In the region, rescue workers are working against the clock to find 8 residents who were missing after their apartment block collapsed in the city of Fortaleza in northern eastern Brazil. One man died when the 7-story building crumbled on Tuesday. 9 people have been rescued alive, but another 8 who are believed to have been inside when the collapse happened are still unaccounted for. Officials said the block had been built without the necessary permits. A small grocery store next to the building was damaged in the collapse, and a man delivering water to the shop, 30-year-old Frederick Santana dos Santos, was killed. Another delivery man, 34-year-old Antonio Gomes Marcelino, managed to get out of the shop alive. Of the 18 residents who were inside the apartment block's 13 flats, 9 have been rescued alive. One of them, architecture student David Sampaio, had sent his family a selfie on WhatsApp in which he was smiling and giving a thumbs up to the camera after the collapse to show that he was alive and well. He told a friend that he had only suffered some scratches. A puppy was also pulled from the rubble alive. Rescue workers are using sniffer dogs to search for the 8 residents who are still missing. The cause for the collapse of the apartment block, which was built in 1995, is not yet clear. Building collapses such as this are not uncommon in Brazil. On the international scene, Democratic Speaker of the House of Representatives, Nancy Pelosi, has refused to hold a chamber-wide vote to authorize the impeachment inquiry, despite vehement pushback from the White House and Republicans. Mrs. Pelosi affirmed on Tuesday that there is no need for a full chamber vote as her party's probe proceeds. There's no requirement that we have a vote, so at this time we will not be having a vote, and I'm very pleased with the thoughtfulness of our caucus with the path that we're on, she told reporters. But Republicans, who control the Senate, where any impeachment measure would go to trial, disagree, citing past impeachments. The president's supporters have called for a full House vote to formally state the inquiry and give Republican lawmakers more powers, like being able to issue subpoenas for their own witnesses and schedule hearings. As it stands, several House committees, all chaired by Democrats, are investigating the president, looking for evidence to support impeachment. The White House has refused to cooperate. We're not here to call bluffs. We're here to find the truth, to uphold the Constitution of the United States, Mrs. Pelosi said on Tuesday. This is not a game for us. This is deadly serious, and we're on a path that is getting us to a path to truth and timetable that respects our Constitution. And that brought us to the end of regional and international news. Now let's take a look at the Guyana Stock Exchange closing prices for trading session 847. Let's turn our attention to the Demo Corporation Purpose for Bridge Schedules. This is where we will wrap up this evening's broadcast, but before we go, here's a reminder of our top stories. Chief Justice fails to rule on cabinet resignation. Two men caught by Khan with over 94 pounds of marijuana. Government-nominated commissioners attempting to remove 20,000 persons from voters' list. And in sport, Ghana Football Federation signs historic memorandum of understanding with the Denmark Football Federation. Catch our rebroadcast at 23 hours today and at 6 hours 30 tomorrow. On behalf of news and technical teams, I'm Ashley Scotland. Good night.